try to be clear. Thank you very much for the organization, to the Napoleonic Society, David Markmans, to send, also to the Academy for the invitation. Nicolai Bronzio, have been doing a great hard work for all of us. Thank you very much for the organizers too, and Katia, etc. And thank you very much for being here, hearing everything we are saying to us, our ideas. To summarize, I'm going to, my research is about prisoners. And in this case, it's how those prisoners, Spanish prisoners, who went to France, changed their opinion about French people. They become to be friends, a real ally. But this image, this individual experience, hasn't passed the boundaries of the public collective memory. Why? Because of several public policies to cut these ideas of friendship with those who were to consider enemies because of the patriotic ideas. And afterwards, I call that there was a process of deconstructing the enemy for the Spaniards and for the French people who support the just cause of the Spaniards. Well, summarizing, the Spanish War began when, in 1807, Napoleon made a deal with Ferdinand VII, and they accord to invade Portugal, and finally what Napoleon was doing was trying to invade Spain. But they used to live with people's food, etc. They took advantage of the women, of the areas they occupied, and suddenly they became enemies for all the people. They considered that they were killing the country, and also there was a very powerful image that has been already appeared here of those enemies, the religious enemies, that image of the devil. And Spain was very religious, as you know. I have a very easy way to resume this image of the Spaniards against the French. It was a quote I take from a prisoner, Spanish prisoner, who was leading to France, and afterwards he could escape, and he told Palafox what the French told him. I quote, when they were asking him, trying, subjected to the court of the ridicule, he said, Balthasar Blaser, this military, they also asked me what surprise Helios was thinking of not to surrender under the imperial eagles, to which I replied saying both General Palafox and the city of Saragossa would defend themselves down to their last drop of blood. At that point, the religion was made fun of. On this subject, Blaser declared that the French gave that to him that the Aragonese had a lot of faith in the Virgin of Pilar, which is made of a piece of wood, saying that they would soon demolish her church and reduce the city of Saragossa to ashes with their bombs, grenades, and cannons, and that the miracles of the Virgin of Good would then be seen. So we have here a very opposite world, the science, the technique, the reason against the faithful, the people who fighting for our religion. And since the war began, those images were very, very strong to have all the billionaires with the Ferdinand VII cause against the French. We have to make some exceptions with the friends of the French people, Afrancesados, and also the people from the north of Spain in Galicia and León, because the British army who went to help them was so strong because they were mercenary and people who drank a lot. commit so many strong things against the people that they used to say, we want to be French. But these are exceptions. And now, going after the war in 1814, we see that as Ferdinand VII made appointments with the French and he wanted to make secret that story, they continue a public policy of the enemies, to continue having the French as enemies. When Ferdinand VII returned, there was a law, an official in the parliament, an official law saying that it was decreed to establish a story that points out the French as the enemies. So everyone has to say that they have been fighting against the French. And also, when the military wanted to continue working as a military, if they had been prisoners, they have to say that they have been fighting and no relationship with their friends. Also, yeah, when they come to ask for any award, etc. And who were those prisoners who went to France in 1809 or until 1814 or 1816? There were military and engineers, so high classes, quite prepared, and there were about 50,000 and 100,000, it depends on the author. But only from Saragossa to Nancy, there were 12,000 military prisoners. Which are the sources I have been considering? Especially private sources, diaries, and several studies, different things that I'm taking to support these theories, and now in this conference I've seen that there are at least several opinions in the same line about this relationship with the prisoners. How many time they spent there in France? I have already told you, around 6 years, 5 to 7 years. It was more time than in the war. So these experiences have to be related because they are very important, more than the Spanish Peninsular War sometimes. And why they made such a good friendship? Because of the way they looked for lodging the prisoners. They used to be, firstly, on military barricades, and when they can make a deal with someone of the village, they want to live to their houses. And they usually were the intellectuals who lodged those prisoners. Then, as those prisoners were elite prisoners, they used to have a lot of liberty, and they used to go to the libraries, the universities, etc. They continue to study. So they made a strong relationship with the professors, the intellectuals. In which way? They belonged to the academy, they went to the sessions of the Royal Academy of Literature, they entered the sociability intellectual groups. Also, they became very, very close to these professors, and they even share their lives. Sometimes they were the good fathers of the sons of those teachers when they had sons. So that means that it was a very, very strong relationship. And sometimes they look for job for those people, for those prisoners. So there were many alliances that at the end of that period of being in this prison, sometimes they call them my great friend. I will never ever forget you. There are several diaries who report this kind of relationships. And I think that maybe this attitude of collaboration and friendship and fraternity is related to Freemasonry. If it was not, maybe it's only with the intellectual connections.
What?
I have to say it. And sometimes they support them in an economical way, etc. And Yes, there have been many sources that speak a few notice about these good relationships, and after the war, sometimes they received the Legion d'Honneur of France, and also they were recognized members of the Academy of Nancy. So that means a very strong things. But what happened? That when they returned to Spain, they began to conceal this relationship. They have to keep it in secret. Because of that official policy, I've already told. And what happened with that experience, this individual experience? They summarize it when they have to give public reports about their experience. They summarize it in one line, saying, I was a prisoner of the French state. So it's like how to be a victim and not to be a coward. So I reported, but I was a victim of the French state. And the cross merits and the awards they received of this Spanish war, it used to be on the liberal period. So after Ferdinand VII was defeated again. That's because it was a great conflict between the friendship, yeah, and the politics of the state. So finally, it arrives this term that I have called deconstructing the enemy, because that things I have already said, that they make big friendship, they help each other, and sometimes the people who host prisoners risk their life because they hid those prisoners against the orders of Napoleon. And why I'm saying also deconstructing the enemy, because even in political sources, in public sources, sorry, you find that support in this case in the Society of Royal Academy of Arts. When the prisoners had left already, they were speaking about public libraries, and then they began to talk about those prisoners, and they say, those brave Spaniards to whom our hospitable city has tend to offer not only the solace that valiant misfortune deserves, but also all facilities to satisfy the most noble of passions, that of learning. Our library and university was for you a refuge that was always open to help you forget the injustice of fortune. So those intellectual links were very strong, and they defended the justice of the fight against Napoleon. So with this affirmation, we can see the lack of hatred between French and Spanish military. And what is more, the cause was supported because it was considered just, and not this imperial politics of invading these other countries. In conclusion, to summarize, we can see the impressive limits of the enemy. We have analyzed how the French enemy became a friend in the eyes of the Spanish prisoners. Likewise, the French themselves considered the work done by Napoleon to be unjust and helped the Spaniards in many cases to go out, to escape from the French state. They defend this idea of the fair situation of the Spaniards with word and action, establishing multiple networks with the prisoners. They support the later materialian symbolically, lodging them in their houses and befriending them in libraries and universities. Sorry. And to things, unfortunately, the attitude of concealing these alliances to favor translational strife has prevailed right up to the present day. Historiographically, the union between the French and the Spaniards has been silenced because it was in opposition to a nationalist and patriotic view of history. However, future research will be done to fill this wide hole, which was perpetuated by war by award at European level with its conciliatory stories. Thank